Today we want to see the topic on interlaced scanning. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of this session, student will be able to explain the concept of interlaced scanning. The contents of these topics are introduction, horizontal scanning, vertical scanning, number of scanning lines, interlaced scanning, and scanning periods. Scanning means the division of picture into many horizontal lines is called scanning. The flickering effect can be minimized with the help of interlaced scanning. And to avoid this flickering, we use interlaced scanning, and minimum picture frames per second requirement is 50. The horizontal line scanning frequency is required for 625 line system with a period of 64 microsecond divided by 2 is equal to 32 microsecond. Now before going to the interlaced scanning, we want to understand first what is the means of horizontal scanning and vertical scanning. Now this figure shows the horizontal scanning of path of scanning beam in covering the picture area. This diagram is drawn width versus height, and here shows start of a line is from top left hand side to right hand side. This will dash line is shows, and this is called as a trace line, and this will dotted line shows the retrace path. This is a trace path and this is a retrace path, and this all these processes happen in the raster. Now that images is shown here. This graph is shown current versus time. This is a horizontal current. Now in this diagram shows waveform of current in the horizontal deflection coil producing linear scanning in the horizontal direction. Here for the first line, it will start from the 0th and it will reach to the maximum IH maximum, and after when it will reach to the maximum, it will suddenly drop down to the zero, current zero, and again it will start and again it will come to zero. The starting from zero to maximum, this path is called as a trace path, and from the maximum point to the zero, it is called as a retrace path. Now this diagram is again shown here in the raster of a 625 lines. For the interlaced scanning, we require minimum 625 lines, and that is explained with the help of this diagram. This diagram shows it will start from the most left hand side, it will start from the zero, it will reach up to this IMAX, and that will be shown here, and when it will reach to the IMAX, it will suddenly drop down to the zero and again it will start. This will called as a trace and this will is called as a retrace. This one cycle of a deflection current is equal to trace plus retrace. Now vertical scanning, same the horizontal scanning, the vertical scanning is a start from the top side, left hand side, top left hand side, and it will reach to the right hand side. This will called as a trace path, and it again it will dotted line shows the retrace path. This dashed line is shows the trace, and this will is the retrace path. This linear vertical retrace, and the retrace is done with the help of this vertical direction. This will be the show the vertical retrace. Now this the previous diagram is explained with the help of this one. Here the vertical current versus time, we drawn the vertical deflection current. Here again it will start from the zeros, it will reach up to this maximum current, and after when it will reach to the maximum current, it will drop down to the zero. This is from zero to maximum current, whichever showing is the vertical trace, and which is the maximum to zero, this will shows the retrace path. That's this is a first frame, second frame. In this way, this up to 625 frames we have to shown here. And this is a raster. This is a W means width and H means height. And this is a trace period. That's the height total. See, the trace period is equal to the height of that raster. That will be the shown here. It will be start from this zero and reach to the maximum, and after that one it will again goes to the zero. This is a path of a trace and this is a path of a retrace. This is a current waveforms in vertical deflection coils. Now number of scanning lines, how many numbers of a scanning lines we require here? For the number of a scanning lines, we require here the dark white, these are the strips, dark white, and this is a beam spot. If we want the correctly the picture transmission in the TV, then the beam spot is correctly mentioned in between this dark and white strips. This is a beam path, and this diagram shows about the scanning this spot perfectly along with the black and white lines. Now, alternate lines are black and white. The electrical information corresponding to the brightness of each bar will be correctly reproduced during the scanning process if it will satisfy these two conditions. Which are these two conditions? One is the thickness of a scanning beam is equal to width of each white and black bar, and second one is number of scanning lines equal to number of bars. Now, this diagram shows critical viewing distance as determined by the ability of the eye to resolve the two space pictures. Now, in this diagram shows D is equal to 4H. This is the eye of the observer. This is a two distant black picture element just resolved. Is the nth bar, n plus 1th bar, and this is a what? Eye angle. And we see here we calculate the eye. Here we calculate the eye distance. How much distance we require to two adjacent black picture elements just resolved. We have to calculate here. Now, the maximum number of alternate light and dark elements which can be resolved by the eye is given by the formula NV is equal to 1 by alpha P. Now, what is this terminology? Where NV is total number of lines, elements to be resolved in the vertical direction. Alpha means minimum resolving angle of the eye expressed in radians. Now, this alpha we want to measure in the radians that we calculated with the help of pi by 180 into 1 by 60. This is a standard value. Now, rho is equal to d by h, that is a viewing distance divided by picture height, is equal to standard value we use here, 4. Substituting the standard values into equation 1, we get, now here pause the video for 2 minutes and you put these standard values into that equation and calculate the what is the value. Okay, after the putting the value of that equation, NV is equal to 1 by pi by 180 into 1 by 60 into 4, we get 860. Means a distinct pickup of the picture information results total number of scanning lines here 860, and the scanning beam just passed over the each bar. Now, the most important part, that is the interlaced scanning. In television pictures, an effective rate of 50 vertical scans per second is utilized to reduce the flicker. This is accomplished by increasing the downward rate of travel of the scanning electron beam so that every alternate line gets scanned instead of every successive line. Thus, the total number of lines are divided into two groups called the fields. Each field is scanned alternatively. This method of scanning is known as interlaced scanning. Now, this diagram shows the principle of interlaced scanning. Here, note that the vertical retrace time has been assumed to be 0. Now, here, it will start from the beginning from the first field, that is first. It will start from the top left-hand side and it will reach to the right side. And after that one, it will go to the left, again right. This will be the trace path. And if you observe this diagram, it will start from the left-hand side at the 0th position. And it will reach for the end of the first field. It will be the at the middle of this line. And after when will it reach the here, then it again retrace path, it will start the middle of this one, and again it will start the for the second field. And in this way, this one is the first field, and in this way in the second field. Now this will process will be done. If you observe in this diagram, it will be the scanning is for different for odd lines and scanning for different for the even lines. Now, for successful interlaced scanning, the 625 lines of each frame or picture are divided into sets of 312.5 lines. To achieve this, the horizontal sweep oscillator is made to work at a frequency of 15,625 Hz. That is how we calculate this one, with the help of 312.5 into 50 is equal to 15,625. Now, scanning periods, the most important concept. Here are two types of scanning periods. One is a horizontal deflection current and second one is vertical deflection current. Now, horizontal deflection current, diagram shows the horizontal deflection current. It will again the total time period is equal to the trace plus retrace. Now, total time period is equal to trace period is we calculate 52 microseconds, and for the retrace it will require 12 microseconds. Therefore, total time become 52 microseconds plus 12 microseconds, that is 64 microseconds. This will t is equal to 64 microseconds, and if we calculate the frequency, it will require 15,625 Hz for this horizontal deflection current. For this vertical deflection current, here the total time required for vertical deflection current is, for the trace it will require 18.720 milliseconds, and for the retrace it will require 1.280 milliseconds. Therefore, the total time required for trace and retrace, we have to add that one. Therefore, total time required is trace plus retrace period, that is 18.720 milliseconds plus 1.280 milliseconds, it becomes 20 milliseconds. And from this time period, we calculate the frequency, that is a 50 hertz for the vertical deflection current. The horizontal and vertical sweep oscillator operate continuously to achieve the fast sequence of interlaced scanning, that is 20 horizontal lines. Now 20 for the even field and 20 for the odd field, therefore it becomes as a 40 lines. Therefore this leaves the active number of lines NA for scanning the picture details equal to 625 minus 40, that is equal to 585. Instead of 625 lines, we use only 585 lines actually scanned per frame. This is a scanning sequence. As we told that for the scanning sequence, we require the scanning for this first field and for the second field is a different. That is for the first vertical trace, it will show, it will start from the 0th position from the left hand side from A to the B and it will reach to the middle of the B. That is the first vertical trace, that is equal to 292.5 lines. That is 1 to 292.5. And after when it will reach to the B, it will again goes to the retrace path that requires 292.5 to 312.5 is equal to 20 lines. Therefore, for the first field, it will require 312.5 lines. And the same sequence is applied for this second vertical trace. And here we get the for second field is a 312.5 lines. That is, if we add this one, we get the one frame picture is equal to 625 lines. Now advantage for this interlaced scanning is to avoid the flicker, it is better than sequential scanning and it conserves the bandwidth. Now difference between the progressive and interlaced scanning. The progressive scanning and interlaced scanning is shown here. First, in the progressive scanning, every successive line is being scanned, but for the interlaced scanning, the first scans the odd lines from the top to bottom and then it scans the lines those are scripted in the previous scanning. The effective number of pictures scanned per seconds are 25 frames per second in progressive scanning, and in the interlaced scanning it requires 50 frames per second. Flicker problems will occur in the progressive scanning, but in the interlaced scanning the flicker problem is avoided. Total number of lines scanned at a time from top to bottom is 625 lines in the progressive scanning. Total number of lines scanned at a time from top to bottom are 312 and half lines for the interlaced scanning. References for this topic. Thank you.